Nó bên là tất nhiên. Hello, bên bên gái đấy. Venga, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
I can hear you.
Okay. Is there any noise in the background? Can you hear me?
Not really. I'm not hearing any noise in the background.
Okay, sorry. I'm waiting for other people to join us so we can start.
Okay, no problem.
Welcome. You are familiar. I didn't care. Welcome. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Okay. Actually, I want us to be at least 10 before we start, but before then. And I wouldn't mind if one or two persons can just talk about their expectation before the class begins. Just two people.
Sorry, I didn't get that.
I said before the class begins, I want just two people to talk about their expectation. What do you expect from this class? Just two. Anybody?
Okay, can I go first?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, good afternoon, everybody, or good evening. Benga. What I expect in this class is to gain more knowledge on Canvas. Yeah, let me just say I'm here for the Canvas training, and definitely for the Corel Draw, no knowledge is lost. So I'll definitely be around for the Corel Draw too, because no knowledge is lost. But I'm here to buttress, sorry, to polish my skills when it comes to doing graphics design on Canvas.
Okay. One more person before we start. We are using this to wait for other people that want to join us. Just one person. More person. Anybody? One person. Anybody?
Hello.
Anyone? Akin, do you want to say something?
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening, Akin.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
All right. Good evening, everybody. I'd like to see Akin. Actually got to join this class through my neighbor, Mr. Titi.
Oh, interesting.
So my expectation for this. So my main purpose for this class and what I'm planning to achieve is to develop my skills and I'll really appreciate you and every day that
okay. Five minutes now. Yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. Adenike, welcome. Akim, welcome. Anuadi, any welcome. Sintemi, welcome. I don't know who is Galaxy 824, but wherever you are welcome here. Benga, we have two Bengas here. Welcome, Benga. Izu Chuku, welcome. Tewe, welcome. Mercy, welcome. Olufumilayo, Makinde, welcome. Sarah, welcome. Tomi, Ayomide, Ifeoluwa, and Linda, welcome. Anyone that is joining us, I say welcome. Okay, now, before we start, based on what we discussed yesterday, please, if you have any comments or any questions, just drop it in the chat section. I will check them out and I will give my comments about everything you're saying. Based on what we discussed yesterday, if you remember, I said that before you design, you have to have a good idea of what you want to design first. That's the best way you can design, you can create any design in a very quick, I'm sorry. That's where you can create designs in a very quick and easy way. Do you understand? A minute. Okay, so I'm going to unmute. Sorry, I'm going to show my face before we start the class. Some people know me, and for those that don't know me, this is Peter. This is the guy that is sending you voice notes yesterday, chatting with you. This is my ugly face. I know I'm awesome, but then it's fine. So let's get straight to the class. So I'll be sharing my screen now so that we can see what Canva looks like. Also, I won't be using my phone. I know a lot of people would think that you use Canva in your phone. Yeah, it's fine. It's actually very, very cool for you to use to design with Canva on your phone. But then if you want to have access to a lot of resources, it's best to use a laptop. But for those that want to, use a phone, you can chat me up later privately. I would see what we can do about that. So I'll be sharing my Canva account with you now. And please, I want you to unmute and tell me if you can see my screen.
I can see your screen.
Yes, we can.
Okay, good.
I can see your screen.
Okay, good. Now, for the past few days, or should I say a week or thereabouts, I've been showing you guys some designs on the group. So you can see some of the designs I've created here. There is the Canva design with the car. So I was trying to create a design here, but I didn't finish it up. So that's why this one is here. This is another design I created on Canva. This is another design. I created this design on my phone. Though I created others on my laptop, but this particular design was created on my phone. In fact, in a bus. So you may need to unmute if you're not saying anything, please. Thank you. Then this is the document, the student guide that I shared with you as well. Also created on Canva. This is another design I created on Canva. This is another design. So these are designs I've created on Canva so far. Okay. So Sorry, some people are disturbing us, so I just have to mute them. Okay, now, if you want to create a design on Canva, you don't have to just go open Canva and you start your design. No, that's not the best way to start. The best way for you to start a design on Canva is for you to first think. Before you create a design, you have your copy. When I say copy, I mean the text, this text here, that you can see here, this text over here, that's what we call copy. The text used on a design is what we call copy. So before you start a design, you have your copy. You should brainstorm your copy. If you are creating it yourself, you have your copy written down. if you are not the one creating it yourself, you should have a copywriter that would come up with those copy yourself for you, rather. So when you have your copy, you brainstorm. When you have this copy, what idea do you want to communicate to people? Sorry, I need to start recording this class. Good, okay, I've done that. Let's go back to Canva. So like I was saying, you need to brainstorm the idea you want to pass across in your design. Now looking at this, I'm going to recreate this design from scratch. I'll delete everything. Everything I have here, everything. So you can see how I created it. Now this is a blank page. When you have a blank page, as a designer or a business owner that wants to design, you have to be able to think of the copy. Now, what I want to communicate to people is the fact that good designs are not just done on Photoshop. They are not just done on CorelDRAW or Affinity Designer. They are also done with Canva. So I want to just create something that when people see, they will stop and look at the design and say, wow, this is great. And I want to use the copy for my class saying Canva design can also look like this. Then the time and the date and everything will be there. So I'm about to start. I want to know if you guys are following. Just send me a message in the chat box if you are following, or you can unmute and say something.
Yeah, sure, we are following. We are following.
Okay. Any other person? Okay, good. 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 Now, before you start designing, there's something we call resources. Akim, you are raising your hand. Do you want to say something? Akim, do you want to say something?
No, no, sir. I only signify that.
Okay, so when you are done, just click on that button again so your hands will not be raised. Okay, now, before you design, there's something called resources. You need to have your resources down. What are resources? Resources are your images, sometimes your fonts, you know, the things you are going to put together in your design to create that design. That's what we call resources. Now, for me, the only resources I need for this design is the image of the car, then the smoke, then the text. Those are the three things I need for this to create that design. Now, I created that design in less than 2 minutes on Canva, but I'm not sure if I want to do that with you because I would want you guys to learn and ask questions. So I'm about to start now. I have a folder where I keep all my images, but before we start, please, I would need to introduce you to the interface of Canva. First, this is templates. This is where you see different templates of designs that you can follow, be it logo, flyer, document, anything.
Sorry, sir. I want to say something. Sorry, please. Sorry for interrupting.
Go ahead.
I used Canva on my phone, not on my PC, and my home like this.
Okay. Yes,
did you get me?
Yes, I get you. You can mute. Now, like I said before we started, I said that for those that are using Canva on your phone, you can chat me privately. Probably we'll organize a short class where I would explain the interface of Canva on your phone. But if you want to have access to a lot of resources on Canva, you need to use your laptop. That's the best way you can have access to a lot of resources on Canva. If you are using phone, you are going to be limited. There will be some things you will not be able to have access to on your phone. But if you can use a laptop or a pad, when I say pad, I mean iPad, you'll be able to have access to a lot of resources, a lot than you can even imagine. So I'll continue. I said I want to tell you about the interface of Canva. Here, this is where we have the templates. You can see different templates here, logo, flyers, a lot of templates here. Now, in upload, the images you upload to Canva, you get them here. In upload, so you can see all these images. The images, some of them I've manipulated them in Photoshop before bringing them here. So these are all the images I've uploaded myself on my own account. On photos, if you want to download images from Canva, some of them are premium and some are not premium. But if you use my link to create an account for yourself on Canva, some of these images that are here are going to be free for you. even though they are premium for others. So this is one of the resources you are going to enjoy if you use my link to open an account for yourself on Canva. And also, you can have access to elements. Elements basically means shape, you know, your dots, your shapes, your lines, anything you want at all you want to put on the design to make it look jazzy, not jazzy, you know. So there are a lot of elements here. You can see this is like a GIF. There are a lot of elements here that you can put on your design. Here is for text. And I need to explain this part of this text to you. There's something you need to understand here that is very, very important. Let me see if I can go back to the design I deleted so I can explain it better. Now, if you look at this design, something must catch your attention first. And I want to assume, I'm not you, I want to assume that the first thing that caught your attention is this car and this Canva designs. These two things should be the first thing that caught your attention. Now, if you look at everything here, after these two catches your attention, then we have this black one, then this small, then this red one. Why is that so? That is the rule. That's what we have here on this side. We can see that here we have add a heading, add a subheading, add a little bit of body text. This is the heading. This is the subheading. And these are the body text, the little body text. So it means that when you are designing, you must have a text that is the biggest, which is your heading. Then you have another one, which is the subheading, and you have another one, which is the little body of text. Do we all understand? You can just drop a comment. Hello.
Yes, we do.
Okay, I can see. You muted. Okay, so I'm going to delete this. Like I said, I'm going to delete that. So we can create it from scratch ourselves. Now, in this text pattern, this your heading is the biggest text. The subheading is the least bigger text, or let me say the bigger text. Sorry, you shouldn't see your face, just off the video. Thank you. And this little body of text is the smallest. Now, if you follow this pattern in your design, there's something called hierarchy and emphasis in design. When you follow this pattern, where you have your heading, subheading, and the little body of text, it means you are following hierarchy. It means your text or your design is hierarchical. And hierarchy is one of the things that gets people to view your design. Because if all your texts are equal, if they are the same, which one should people read first? Which one should they read second? And which one should they read third? They won't know. But when you make something the biggest, then the second one is like the subheading, then the little body of text. Anybody that sees your design would first read the heading, the subheading, and the little body of text. And one thing I want you to put in mind as designers or as a business person, I want to use Canva to design, is that you are not just designing for yourself. You are designing because you want to communicate to people. You cannot be telling everybody, come and sell bags and shoes. You can't tell everybody. Your business cannot do it alone. So you need to have a design or a flyer that anybody that sees the flyer will know that, oh, this person is saying that I sell bags. But now imagine if your text, I sell bags, and the picture of your bag, they are the same size, and everything you are writing is the same size, people will not be able to read it. But if the image of your bag is bigger, then come and buy bags is the next thing. Then the price and, you know, maybe your address or your phone number, it will be easy for people to read. You won't be confusing them. Do we all understand? So it's always good when you have something that is the biggest, then the next biggest, then the, so you get to the least biggest. Do we understand? Now, so that's what this text, and Canva on your laptop is so good, and it's a blessing. Because it has even given you a guide on different things you can do. There's a guide of the kind of text you can use. So you can see here, play, that's if you want to do something about TGIF or your weekend, game on. There are different things you can select from here and use. But I'll come back to that. Let's keep on learning about the interface on Canva. Now we have audio. Now this is for people that want to create video on Canva. I hope you know that you can also create videos on Canva. In case you don't know, oh, wow, I'm sorry. You can actually create videos on Canva. Oh, in fact, can you just see it? There's even a tab for that here where you can import videos, but that's not what we are doing here. But I just wanted to know that's not what we are doing here. So I will just, this is the background. If you don't want your background to be empty, you don't want it to be white. There are different background templates you can select from here on Canva. And folders, this, if you want to buy anything on Canva, you know, you can have Canva Pro, you can have Canva Free. So anyone you want to use, that's all you have here, but that's not really our concern. Let us go back to what we are doing. So now, what I want to do is to import the image of the car, the smoke, and the text. Now, I already have them here, so I don't want to assume that you all know how to import these images here. So I would delete them and import them again. So I will delete this and this. These are the two images I'm going to delete here. Now I'm going to teach us how to import images. But first, the images has to be on your phone or on your laptop. Actually, there's a way you can access images on Shutterstock and iStock.com. Though it's not free, but then we can always discuss that even during the class or after the class. But let us go straight to the images we have currently. So if you want to upload any image on your Canva so that you can design, you come to upload media. It's over here, this purple button here at the top. I want to believe everyone is looking at this. You can see my mouse hovering around it. So you just click on upload media. It's asking us, do we want to upload it from our device? Device here is the laptop or your phone, or from Facebook or Google Drive or Instagram or Dropbox. Dropbox is also like Google Drive. But then I have my images on my laptop, so I'm just going to click on device. Now, this is the folder where I have a lot of images that I can use for my designs. I have all my assets, not all, but most of my assets already downloaded. So I'll just go and look at the image of the car and the image of the smoke as well. So I'm just scrolling to just get the images that I want. I want to believe everyone is seeing this. So I will just click on the image of the car. Then I click on open. And it's going to upload here. You can see it's uploading. So I don't want to assume that everyone got it straight like that. So I'm going to upload the image of the smoke as well. So if you don't get the way I uploaded the image of the car, please follow the way I'm about to upload the image of the smoke. So I'm going to click on upload media. I'll click on device. Then I'll select the image that I want. But because the image is not here, I'll just scroll to the image. So I'm scrolling. I'm using my mouse to scroll. And this is the image of the smoke here. I'll click on it. Then I'll click open and it's loading here. You know, the big thing about Canva again is that if you want to bring these things, if you want to bring them from here to this your Canva, this thing is called Canva. An empty sheet of paper where you want to design is called Canva. For an artist that wants to draw, that empty paper that you draw on is called your Canva. Now, if I want to import these images from here to here, it's not even stressful at all. All you just need to do is just click on the image. Don't click here. If you click here, it means you are selecting. So don't click here. Just click on the image itself. And you can see the image is already imported. For the smoke as well, just click on the image and it's already imported. But it's just an overlay. So you can just move it away. You see it. So now, this is where you now have to pay art attention. Because I'm about to create the exact designs that you saw. Now, what do we do? We click, just click on this image. You know the smoke has to be at the bottom end here. So you can just reduce the size of this. And please be careful. If you're using your laptop, when you want to reduce any image, reduce from the four edges. You either reduce from here, or from here. Please do not reduce from here. Do not come here to adjust your images. Do not come here to adjust your images. And do not come here to adjust your images. If you do, the image will be cropped out. Let me show you a sample. Look at this. Can you see? You don't want your images to be like this. So I'll just press Ctrl Z on my laptop, or you can just come here and click on D. If you edit your image from here, it will also be cropped out. Look at this. You don't want your images to be like this. So I'll just go back. So, but if you are just from here, or from here, or from here, the proportion will still be maintained. So just come here. You can see the image is not cropped. So we just adjust it to be a little bit smaller. Now we move it here. Now you can see that this thing is obstructing. We can't put it together. So in this case, we need to crop out a little bit of this white text. So what do we do? You just come here and crop. You can see that it's cutting. You can come here as well and crop. You can come here as well and crop. You can come here as well and crop. But when you move it from, when you adjust it on this end, it's not going to, there's no cropping. You can see that there's no cropping. So it has to be at the bottom here. Now, what else do you do? This image is not supposed to be here. It's supposed to be on top of the smoke. So what do? You just right click and you click bring to front. Bring to front will bring the image to the front. If you click on bring forward, it will just move it a little bit up. That's if you have a lot of elements around. So just click on bring to front. And you can see that it's already on top of it. Now, there's a little bit of white text here that we don't need. So we want to crop it out. You won't crop it out from here. It won't work. You have to crop it out from here. A little bit. You can see. Now, we need to adjust. If you can remember the design, let me see if I can go back to that design. A minute. Oh, I can't. Okay. No problem. We'll create everything. Now, what you just need to do is click on this. And on your laptop, hold the shift key. The shift key. You hold on it and you click here as well. The two of them have been selected. You can see. Now we need to turn them. We need to turn them around. You know, the original design has the car going in this direction, like this, not in this direction. So we need to turn them. You just click on this image, hold your shift key and click on the smoke. Then come here and you turn it. Can you see? Now we want it to be bigger. You won't adjust it from here. You have to adjust it from here. And you can just put it here. Can you see? Now, we want to now include the text. The text that says Canva design can also look like this, with date, the time, and every other thing. So what do? We come to text. This is the text I used. This one, you can see it's even under recently used. You just click on it and it will appear. Can you see it here? Now, this is too big and this is not the way we want it to look like. But you know what? Let's just adjust it first. When we are done with the adjustment, then we turn it as well. So what do? This thing has been grouped. You have to ungroup it. You just click on ungroup. You right click and click on ungroup. Now, here you type Canva Designs. Canva Designs. Then here we have, can also look like this. Can also look like this. Can we see that? Then the date and the time and every other information here. Here I wrote, join us for a free class to learn how to use Canva like this. Then we have our time, 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. We don't need this, so let's just delete it. Now, if you can remember, this text was red. I know one beautiful thing, that's one of the reasons why I say it's always good to use Canva on your laptop. One beautiful thing is that the moment you upload any image on Canva, Canva would automatically sieve out the images for you, the colors from that image for you to use. So you just click on the text here and come here. Now, before I talk about this, let me talk about this, the arrows here. I'm sorry. Now, if you look up here, there are a lot of things here. and I'll tell you what everything means. This is the font you are using, the name of the font. So if I want to change the name of, if I want to change this font to any other one, I can just select it here. You can see it's changing. I can select anyone I want to use here. But I want to just stay with this non-Western. And I just click on it and it stays there. This is where you reduce the size of the font, whether you want to make it smaller or you want to make it bigger. And if you don't want to use this button, maybe this button is too slow for you, you can just click on this here and just type the number you want. So if I want 200, you can see very big and even out of the page. If I want to be smaller, I can just come here and probably press 80. You can see smaller. If I want it to be 20, if I want it to be 100 again, you can see that. This is where you give your text color. So you can see there's text color. So when you just click on it, it shows you a lot of colors you can use. Now, one of the reasons why I said it's good to use Canva on your laptop is that you can see from the image of the car alone, Canva already sees out 5 colors from this image alone. And even from this smoke alone, Canva already sees out another 5 colors. You can see this is so beautiful with Canva. Although CorelDRAW can as well do this, but then it requires a lot of expertise. There's a way you can actually do this on CorelDRAW, but CorelDRAW will not do it for you automatically. CorelDRAW will not just do this for you automatically. So I want this to be red. I'll just click on it and it's red. So we now need to select everything and turn it around. But before we do that, let me explain all these other elements very well. Now, if you want to bold your text, this is where you come. If you want to make it italics, this is where you come. This one is for alignment. You want it to be, as it is, it's aligned to the left. If you want it to align to the right, or you want it to be at the middle, this is where you are adjusting. Let me do that so that you can see it. You can see it's aligned to the middle here, and it's aligned to the right here. And now I'm taking it back to the left. This is for you to see if you want to give it bullet points. But I'm not sure what to do that in this class. So just click it, you just take it off. Now, this is for the line height. If you want this space here, you want it to be reduced, or you want it to be bigger, this is where you come. So you just come here, click on it, and you can reduce this inside the space or increase it. But the space that I did before is actually two. So we just take it back to something like that. And this is fine like this. This is the space in between the letters. And you can see letter spacing. So you can increase it or reduce it. You can see. Please, when you are designing, all these things are very, very important. Because people are reading. People are going to be reading. So anytime you are designing, you are not designing for yourself. You must not make the space to be too much that people cannot be able to read it. Or make it too small that people will be thinking, what did you write? So you have to make it proportional. Let it be moderate. That even you can read. This is effect. You want to give your text effect. But I'm not sure, we are not giving our own effect. So we don't need that. Let's just go back to what it is before. So before our time runs out, you just click here, click on this, and you rotate it as well. You can see. And you bring it here. And we are done with our design. Do you have any question? I'm sorry because of the time. This is the only one I've been able to do so far. I'm hoping that we'll be able to do another one. But let me know if you have questions before I proceed. Any question?
Sir, I think there are some questions on the short course.
Okay, let me check the how to merge images. Oh wow. How to merge images again? How to merge images? How the width and height. Okay. Yeah. Let me do that again. Let me just go back. So if you know you asked that question, please pay attention now. Or let me just do this thing. So first, those images were not merged. They're actually separate. But there's a way I put them together. Let me just do that all over again so you can all see. I imported the first image and the second image. These are them separately. And I told you that you shouldn't adjust from here. because it's going to crop out your image. So don't adjust from there, but rather adjust from this. Wait, someone say something. Please, disturbing others, please. Okay, I can't see the person. Okay, let's just continue because of our time. Now, these are the if you know you asked the question about merging, please and please watch well now. What I just did was to move this, I made this image smaller. Then I made this one too as well smaller. Then I brought this here. Now, because this image is on top of this car, and I don't want it to be like that. All I just need to do is just click on this car, I right click, and I click on bring to forward. And it's up. So, but you know what we have here? Let me make it bigger so that you can see it clear. What we have here is not really cool. We need to cut out this small space here. So you just click on this and you cut it out from here, not from here. If you cut this from here, you are making it smaller or bigger. But you want to crop it out, you have to use this place. You can see it has been cropped. Then I just click on this and click on this. And you can actually group them if you want, but you may not group them. So for the purpose of those that say, how did I merge it? So I'm going to group them so that you can see. How do you group? You right click and you click on group. Now you can adjust it and it's still the same thing. You can see. So I hope you got the way I merged the images. Then I also imported the text because of our time. In the next few minutes, we are going to be cut out. So let me just quickly add the text again. This is the text I used. I in groups. Then here I typed Canva designs. And here I wrote can be like this too. Join us to learn how to design with Canva. So this is too big, so we need to reduce it. Don't forget, what we just need to do is we come to this place and reduce it. Oh, sorry, I've selected the wrong thing. We just come here and reduce the text. You can see. Sorry, there are some comments again in chat section. Let me just take them out. Someone said I want to connect my hotspot to my laptop so I can check later. So the recording for this class will be available. In case you don't miss anything, you can always go back to watch. Then someone says again, how do you group if you're using your phone to design? That's another thing. Please, I should send the image. Okay, no problem. I'll send the images to everyone. I'll send it to the group so everyone can access and see it. One thing is that there are some things you don't have access to. If you're using your phone to design, there are a lot of things you are not going to have access to. But if you know you want to really learn how to design just using your phone without a laptop, that's not a problem. I will organize another class after this, just maybe a 30-minute session, and I'm going to show you how you can use your phone. But in that one, I have to record it first. I will upload it online so you can go and watch. Do we all understand? So what I did was I deleted this, then I made this red. From the text color, I selected this color, then I selected everything, and you know, I bent them. And please, if you are bending your design, don't make it so bent that people will not be able to read it. Being able to read it is also important. So I wouldn't want to bend my text like this. People will not be able to read it. That's if you bend in a way that people will still be able to read it, in as much as your message is not lost. Can you see this? We'll be caught up in the next 3 minutes. I wish we can do more about this. I don't know if I should just click create another design. If I attend the Canva class, can I also? Yes, you can learn the Corel Draw class if you know you want to learn Corel Draw as well. So you can look at the way I designed on the two of them, and you know, you select the one you want to use moving forward. Let me see if I can just quickly create the design now. Though I'm not going to talk, I'm not going to explain anything. Just watch me as I create a new design. Because of our time is almost fast spent. Just watch me. Just, let's talk about football. Let's say something about football. Nah, this is not good enough. Let's look for another one. So we need to give it text, a good color. And you know, Canva will see that color for us. So I just select this. We don't need that background. That background is not needed. We don't need it. So we need to remove that background. We just come to effects. You see, we just select the raw one. Oh, sorry, I just made a mistake. I should adjust this from here. You can say soccer is a beautiful day, you know? So we need another sub-heading text, a very sweet one. It's a beautiful day. I make it bold. They're going to be cut out very soon. Very soon. Yes, this. Let me export this design. So someone once asked me that, you know, they were importing their designs and it was not quality. So how do you import your design? You come here, you click on download. Then please ensure you're importing in PNG. PNG has more quality than JPEG. Don't select JPEG. JPEG loses quality, but PNG has no quality. So just select PNG and you download. You can see it's downloading the design. I have to save the design on my phone. Soccer. And it's saved. So someone asked a question. What if I want particles in the background? If you want particles in the background, it's very simple. Just come to the background here and select whatever particle you want. Now, this is not so permissible. Sorry, let me delete this and use another one. Now, if you look at this, someone asked a question.
Yeah, I noticed that the background of most of these pictures that you've been using actually white, and the background of the picture itself is white. Now, because sometimes when I do Canva designs, I notice that when I use a picture that is not white background, like what is happening on this soccer, you can see that line between that soccer and this white background. When the picture itself is white, it affects the image. How can I blend the image of the picture I want to use with the image of the Canva that I've been used? Okay. Now the
I get your question. I get your question. So someone says, also, how do I know that an image is in PNG? If you want to know how an image is in PNG, just look at the image file. It's not going to be JPG, it will be PNG. Now, so the question that, I don't know who asked the question, how can you remove the background? Now, Canva cannot remove background for you, except I think if you go to the pro version, there's a way you can remove background. I'm not so sure. But then, let's leave Canva. How can you remove background? Just go to, sorry, who is in this? Someone is doing something here. Please, if you are the one, please stop. Just go to remove.bg. Remove.bg. Let me see if I can type it here. Remove. Let me make it general to everyone. Remove.bg. If you go to remove.bg, you can input your images there. Just upload your images there. Your images is going to be downloaded as PNG without any background. Let me see if I can still do that to this. That means I have to start sharing my entire web. So hold on. I want to stop sharing and I want to share again. Okay. Please let me know if you can see what I'm doing. I'm going to remove the BG. Please let me know if you can see this.
Yeah, sure, you can see it. You can see it.
Yeah, so this yes, is, we can.
This is remove.bg. You want to remove your remote, you want to remove your background. This remove.bg. You can just click here. You upload the image of the design you want to, the image that you want to remove the background from. I'm going to select mine very soon. Hold on, I'm trying to get it. Yeah, this is it. So just click here. It will remove the background for you. You download it and the background will be off. You can see the background has been removed. So you just click on it or you click on download and you can save it. So because of our time, I'm trying to rush up. Now, let's go back to Canva.
Lisa, can I ask a quick question?
Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Go ahead.
Okay, you said it's better to import an image in PNG. What if I have an image or I download an image and it's in JPEG? How do I convert it to PNG?
You have to go to remove the BG, to remove the background, except you are using the pro version of Canva.
Okay, PNG means there is no background in the picture. Is that what it means?
Yes, that's what it means.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Not the picture yet. I'm sorry, we might be coming very soon. But if you go to remove the BG, I always get a version that. Sorry, please 1 minute. I want to see where the image is. Oh. Can't I like this thing? Now. I'll just upload the image and you see that the background has been removed. Let me just delete this. You can see that the background has been removed already. From that website, remove.bg. You can see. Can we all see that? Any question? Because I'm going to be cut off very soon now. Any question? I'll be sure to where I remove the background.
Yes, sir. There's a question on the chat box.
Can we do this again? This class is too short. Jesus.
Linda.
Consider
Linda.
Boss, please. Can you send? Sorry. Please, can you send those pictures to us? The car image and the flame image.
No problem. I will do that. Even the soccer.
Mr. Peter, thank you so much, Mr. Peter.
Sir, what about some? Can you give us some sites where we can get quality pictures?
I would type that out. We have Pixels. Let me type it down here. Pixels. Okay,
thank you, sir.
.com. We have iStock.com, iStockphotos.com. We have Shutterstock. I use Shutterstock, but Shutterstock is page. And iStock is also page. iStock.com, Shutterstock.com. There are many others like that. We have Unsplash. Don't worry, I would give you a detailed list of places where you can download free images. We also have Pixabay. There are many others, but don't worry, I'm going to drop them in the group chat so that we can all see them. But you know what? I need to end this class now for us to do the Canva class, because the Canva class is supposed to start now. Sorry, I said Canva, the Corridor class is supposed to start now. If you want to learn Corridor, you can join us. If not, see you when next you meet. But don't worry, I'm going to put out resources for everyone so that you can get to see all these things I've listed. Thank you. I have to end this class now. Thank you so much. Thank you. I appreciate everyone. Thank you.